Hello makers and fixers, and welcome to Sarawak. So most of you are probably pretty familiar with the idea of pen turning, and with pen turning comes this. This is the standard sort of pen mandrel that you slide the tube for the pen on here and you turn it between centers. However, my friend recently got some of these. These are a fountain pen for wood turning, but you can't insert any guide all the way through because it has to have a closed off end here. So this video is about how to make this type where you cannot use one of these. So let's get to it. So yeah, it looks interesting. I think I'll keep this one. I'll straighten the edges off. So I've measured this and I'm pretty sure this is set up as a 3/8, but I don't have a 3/8, so I've got a 9.5, which is almost the same. It's a little bit smaller, but hopefully we won't have any problems with it. So what I'm going to do is mark the depth that this has to go in. So it's going to go to there. And that will allow it to go all the way into the block when it's finished. We'll start it out slow. It's a big drill, we don't want to cause too much. what I will do is, because I now know how deep that hole is, what I can do is mark on here how deep the hole is so that I know how long I need to cut to make sure I don't cut into that hole. I'm going to grab this. This like that, and I'll put a mark there, and I'll give it half a centimeter beyond that, and that'll be my end of my pen when it's done. To glue my bits. Now, as I said, I put a 9.5 millimeter drill bit through this, and my measurement says it probably should have been 9. So that can sit like that. And when we turn that down, I'll be able to take that off anyway, so I'm not real worried by it. So I'll leave that to firm up over an hour or so. put on some of that good old boiled linseed oil. See if we can get this off nicely. So here we are, that's the end. I've assembled everything, I still need to let it cure a little bit and then I'll clean up a bit around here where I've still got a bit of a mess. So in the end, I certainly should have used a different live center to the one that I did, because that did throw the whole piece out of alignment, and I've ordered one to correct that for future turnings. But I still think it turned out pretty nicely, and I hope you enjoyed the video. Like it if you liked it, subscribe if you want to see more, but most importantly, have fun making things, guys.